Learning how to use a compass with a map is one of the most important skills you'll learn for the outdoors. It will ensure that you know where you are and what direction to go in to get to your destination.
In this video, we'll learn how to orient a map using a compass, take a bearing, the difference between true north and magnetic north, and adjusting for declination.
Correctly orienting your map helps you orient yourself to your surroundings.
A useful time to do this is at track junctions to check where you are on the map, or at lookouts and open areas to identify any landmarks you can see.
Firstly, find a flat surface to put your map and compass on. Can you read the words? If not, flip the map until you're reading it like a book. Line up the orienting lines of the compass with the grid lines on the map. Make sure that north on the bezel is lined up with the index marker.
Next, turn your map until the needle points to the angle of declination. For this map, it's 23.5 degrees. But so long as the needle points around the 20 degree mark, you'll be close enough. Now our map is facing north, so have a look at your surroundings and see if you can identify any prominent features on the map. Another great skill you can use your compass for is to take a bearing.
This is especially useful if you can't figure out where the track is heading, which can often happen above the bush line or in open terrain. Take the straight edge of your compass and line the bottom of the ruler up with your current position. Now pivot the compass so that the top of the ruler lines up with your destination. You now have a straight line between you and your destination. Rotate the bezel so that the orienting lines align with the map's grid lines.
Now, read the number on the index marker. In this case, it's 50 degrees. Now, the angle of declination might sound complicated, but it's actually quite simple. It's all to do with the difference between true north and magnetic north.
If this ball is Earth, then true north is the direct line from where you are to the top of the Earth, aka the North Pole.
This line is represented on the topo map by north-south grid lines and is referred to on the map as grid north. However, the needle on our compass points to magnetic north,
which isn't actually the North Pole. In fact, it's slightly off in the Arctic Ocean, just north of Canada. This means that our compass points in a different direction. Therefore, we need to compensate for this difference between the two poles in order to find our bearings.
This difference is our angle of declination. To calculate this, there are three points to work off.
One, our position. Two, the position of true north. Three, the position of magnetic north. If we draw a line from our position to true north and another from our position to magnetic north, then the angle between the lines is the declination. As you move around the Earth, the declination changes. In New Zealand, the value is somewhere between 18 and 24 degrees east. Luckily, our topo map has a handy guide at the bottom that lets you know the declination for the area that we're in.
A general rule of thumb is to add the declination when adding a bearing to the map, and taking away the declination when taking a bearing from the map. As we are taking a bearing from the map, this means I need to take away 23.5 degrees from the bearing I have of 50 degrees. So I just need to locate 26.5 degrees on the bezel and rotate it until it lines up with the index marker. Now pick up your compass and turn your whole body until the needle is over the orienting arrow. Now just follow the direction of travel arrow at the top of the compass.
You don't want to be wandering around with a compass in hand the whole time, so here's a quick tip. Find a landmark in the distance that the direction of travel arrow is pointing. Put your compass away and walk to that point. Use your compass again when you get there to find another landmark to head towards.
It's a lot to take in, but a compass is an extremely useful tool to have in the outdoors. So take the time to understand how it works and practice.